ஓம் அஜ்ஞானதிமிரந்தஸ்ய ஜ்ஞானாஞ்ஜனா சலாகய சக்ஷூர் உன்மிலிதம் யேன தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குருவே நமஹ. ஜெய ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ண சைதன்ய பிரபு நித்யானந்த ஸ்ரீ அத்வைத கதாதர ஸ்ரீவாசதி கௌரபக்தவிருந்த. ஹரே கிருஷ்ணா ஹரே கிருஷ்ணா 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 ஹரே ஹரே, ஹரே ராம ஹரே ராம 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 ஹரே ஹரே. Here in this chapter, the brahmana's wives blessed. The main point in this chapter, you know, first one is these brahmana's wives, they are delivered because of their krupa siddhas. You know, just like Sukadev Goswami and Bali Maharaj, these brahmana's wives are krupa siddhas. They are delivered by the mercy of Krishna. Number two, the Lord Krishna wanted to show that these brahmanas, actually, even though they are very austere and all, they did not receive the mercy of Krishna. Hindi translation. Hare Krishna. Jo Hindi translation FM radio pe sun sakte hain. 88.8 frequency. And then he showed that even though the brahmana's wives, they are not austere, or they have not done any, gone through all these, you know, purificatory processes and all, still they got the mercy of Krishna, they got love of Krishna. So one day, Krishna and Balaram, along with all the associates, they left early without taking their tiffins from Mother Yashoda, right? Every day, this is Gocharan Leela. This Gocharan Leela, Srila Prabhupada says, it is a very, very important Leela. And then the devotees, they should hear again and again and meditate on this pastime of Gocharan Leela. Going, every day going, and every day coming back from the Gocharan Leela. So it is mentioned that every day Mother Yashoda, she would pack tiffin, sometimes curd rice, some sweetmeats, sandesh and all that, right? And all the other covered boys also, they pack their tiffins and all, various kinds of foodstuffs, right? Like one devotee asked Prabhupada, even pure devotees also, they are in anxiety. Srila Prabhupada said, no, pure devotees usually they are not in anxiety because they are completely dependent on Krishna. But still, I have one anxiety. And then the disciple asked Prabhupada, what is your anxiety? I want to know what is there in Krishna's lunchbox today. Right? Oh, must be sandesh, because Prabhupada, Krishna likes sandesh, and Prabhupada also used to like sandesh very much. And Harishwari Prabhu, every day he would keep some sandesh in the night time for Prabhupada. Then, this Leela. Then Srila Prabhupada said, anybody who is connected to Hare Krishna movement, one day they can take part in the picnic of Krishna and Balaram. So, like that, if you meditate on this pastime of Gocharan Leela and Krishna Balaram picnic, one day we can also join, right? So, it is so as simple as that. So every day Mother Yashoda would pack, and then she would run behind him, go behind him, she would caution, she would request Balaram, please take care of Kanaya, tell him not to jump into the river, tell him not to play with the horn animals, like that. So she keeps on giving instruction, coming behind. So it is said that acharyas say that at one point of time, at one age, the sons usually, they don't like mothers company so much because they want to play with their you know friends of their own age. So then Krishna would say, Ma, please now you go back. I know every day like that. So, but mother is mother like that. And all the residents of Vrindavan, they would actually gather in different places on the way where Krishna is going. And especially the covert girls, the gopis, they would hide behind some of the bushes and on the terrace somewhere, and they want to have a glimpse of Krishna going to Gocharan, you know, because for almost 8 hours they will not be able to see Krishna. And then sometimes the mothers, one mother-in-law, she was instructing her newly wedded Bahu, she just came, that, you know, please, you know, during this time, you know, please don't go out. Right? There is one black snake, Kala Sarpa, he will bite you and then you will lose your consciousness. Like that. And then, but that lady, she didn't listen. And then she also accompanied other gopis to see, have a glimpse of Krishna. And she was hiding behind a bush. And then Krishna saw that, you know, new girl, you know, has entered. Who is this, you know, new girl? And then he pinched one cough, right? And then she ran towards that gopi, and Krishna, in order to, with the excuse of fetching that cough, he went behind that cough, and that girl was standing there, you know. Then he cast his loving glance, you know, he casted his cooling glance on that gopi. And then as it was predicted by her mother-in-law, you know, she became, you know, like a, she stood still like a painting in the picture in the painting, they say like that. So she lost, you know, external consciousness like that every day this pastime goes on. Then evening also when they come back, and all the gopis whole day, all the residents of Vrindavan, they are feeling separation from Krishna and they all wait. So in Chaitanya Charitamrita, there is one verse which says that actually when Krishna and Balaram, when they come back, evening time, there is all the calves and cows, they, when they come back, they run. So when they run, so much dust arises and the whole atmosphere is, whole sky is filled with the dust raised by the gopis, these calves and the cows. And it is said that the Mayavadis, they cannot see Krishna, you know, because they think that everything is covered by dust. But actually the gopis, they become very jubilant when they see the dust being raised, because it indicates that Krishna is coming back. Right? That is a symptom that Krishna is coming back, like that. So very like this every day, various pastimes Krishna and Balaram, they perform, especially Lord Krishna. So that day, they, Krishna and Balaram, they indicated, in order to, it is said that, in order to deliver Viprabharya, certain Brahmana's wives, Krishna and Balaram, they left early without carrying their tiffin boxes. Right? I think this village is in Gantoli Gram, right? Gantoli? Gantoli Gram. It's near Mathura. So, then all the cowherd boys, they came to Krishna and Balaram. They told that, my dear Krishna and Balaram, we are feeling very hungry. Right? So, they say that, it is said in Vedas, the greatest enemy of humankind is hunger. Is hunger. So, that is why Srila Prabhupada wanted, you know, nobody within the 10 miles of Hare Krishna temples, they should not go hungry. It is our duty. Without any discrimination, we should distribute prasadam, you know, whoever is hungry, like that. So, it is said that then Krishna told the boys that please go to the sacrificial arena where some of the brahmanas, Angirasa Muni, Angirasa, you know, clan, brahmanas, they were performing sacrifices, right? So you go and tell them that, you know, we are, you know, we have come here, telling our names, chanting of our names, Krishna, and you know, first you chant the name of Balram, then you chant the name of myself, you know, then you tell them that we have come here, we are hungry, we are feeling hungry, you know, they should give some food immediately, some rice and all. So why Krishna told that, you know, don't tell my name first, because he thought that Krishna being a Vaishya, they may not give charity to a Vaishya. Usually charity should be given to only Brahmanas, right? But in worst cases, because thinking that Balram is Kshatriya, at least they will give some charity to him, like that. So like that, thinking like that, Vishnacharaka Thakur comments that actually these Brahmanas, they are performing sacrifices to get promotion to heavenly planets. So they are actually in slumber of ignorance. So by chanting our names, Krishna and Balram, loudly, you know, wake them up from their forgetfulness, wake them up from their slumber of ignorance. Like that, that is why, that is the understanding of Krishna Thakur. That, you know, Krishna, that's why Krishna told, you chant our names loudly first, like that. Then all the coward boys, they went to, as per the instruction of Krishna, they went to the sacrificial arena where all these brahmanas are performing sacrifices. They offered they offered obeisances by falling flat on the ground. So Srila Vishwanatha Thakur comments that actually the brahman, when the coward boys, they are fallen on the ground, even though they are only vaishyas, they are looking very, very affligent, more than the brahmanas who are standing on the land of Vrindavan watching them. Who are these boys? Like that. Then they said, oh earthly gods, please hear us. We coward boys are executing the orders of Krishna and were sent by Balaram. Right? Were sent by Balaram. You know? So please give us some acknowledge our arrival. Throughout the incident, the brahmanas, they did not actually care for the coward boys. They were only talking. These coward boys only, they were talking. So Vishnacharaka Thakur comments that actually we have been sent by Krishna, who is more powerful than Balarama. You know, by the order of Krishna, who is more powerful than Balarama? Because he is son of Nanda. So we have come here, and then Balarama has requested for some rice. So indicating that if you give some rice, first we will feed Balaram, then we will feed Krishna, and then we will eat. That is the meaning of this verse. Then the verse that is there on the board. Lord Rama and Lord Achyuta are tending their cows not far from here. They are hungry and want you to give them some of your food. Therefore, O Brahmanas, O best of the knowers of religion, if you have faith, please give some food to them. So, it may say that the brahmanas may say that because Krishna and Balaram, because they are not brahmanas, you know, we don't like to give the food right now. Then coward boys, they have quoted that anasya shuditam patram, the first priority should be given to those who are feeling hungry, right? Those who are feeling hungry, like that. Especially, and that is why you know, like Radha Govind Maharaj says that whenever you call brahmanas for some function, First, you feed them first, then they will give, they will do very nice service, right? Bhuka Brahman, share barabar, right? A hungry Brahman is equal to lion, you know. So he'll become very angry, chit-chita, you know, cranky and all. So that is why it is advised, Brahmanas should be fed first. You know, you should not leave Brahmana hungry, right? If you leave Brahmanas hungry, they become angry, right? So, but Sudras, he says, Sudras, they should not be given food first. If you feed them nicely, they will eat nicely and go and sleep. They will not do your work. So if you keep their stomachs hungry, then they will work. Because unless we work, they won't get food like that. So, Kshudra, so it is, you should give them. If you have faith, my dear Brahmanas, please give Krishna and Balaram food first, because why are you neglecting to give food to Krishna and Balaram, whose names, simply by the mention of whose names, the whole world will drool in ecstasy simply by hearing their names. We are very surprised that actually you are not reacting at all. You are not at all. That is why they are saying that in sarcastic way, that you know, you are actually knowers of religion, dharma vittama. If you are not giving food to Krishna and Balaram, even though you are known as dvija, you know, dvija means you know, second initiated, but actually you are not second initiated, you are simply taken birth from two people, dvija, that is the meaning. Another meaning is given, that dharma vi tama, if you are not giving food to Krishna and Balaram, dharma vi tamaha means you are devoid of any knowledge, you are completely in ignorance. Dharma vi, you know, like that. That is another meaning, like that. So Srila Prabhupada writes in this regard, now the coward boys, they're seeing the hesitation of on the faces of Brahmanas. Coward boys are teaching the Brahmanas. They are, you know, they are telling them that actually you may be hesitating that right now in between we cannot give you the food. Then it is then they said, but actually after initiation and before the animal sacrifice, one should not eat food. But once the animal is sacrificed, you know, you can eat food. So Srila Prabhupada says, even though coward boys, they are only coward boys, small boys, they knew the intricacies of performing Vedic yajnas and the rules and regulations. So that's why Prabhupada says, because they know Krishna, so they know everything. Right? If you know Krishna, you know everything. That's why Srila Prabhupada says. So all these scientists and all, they come. Sometimes I call them rascals. They won't say anything. Sometimes I defeat them because I may not be expert in science. But because I know Krishna, I can convince them. Right? If you know Krishna, you know everything. Like that. So, Yomam evam asammudo janati purushottamam sasarva vidbhajati mam Sarvabhavin Bharata. You know, anybody who knows without any doubt, Yomam Evam Asam Mudo, Janati Purushottamam, I am the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Sasarvavid. Sasarvavid means he knows everything. That means he studied four Vedas, he studied 108 Upanishads, he studied all Dharma Shastras, he studied all the Vedanta Sutra, everything he studied. Right? 18 Puranas. He knows everything. Why? That is why Sarvabhavin Bharata, he will worship me with great love. You know, Krishna says in 15th chapter, 19th verse. So, that is why Prabhupada is saying that, you know, even though the Brahmanas, they are well read in Vedas and all, they did not bother to reply to the coward boys. So, why they did not, even though they are well read and Vedas and all, why they did not reply, pay heed to the request of the cowherd boys. So it is commented that actually, even though they are performing the sacrifices, even though they have read Vedas, but actually they did not know the scriptures and they did not know the intricate meaning of the scriptures. So it is very, very important. You know, sometimes you simply read Vedic books, you know, you get only simply by knowing Sanskrit, you know, you cannot understand Vedas. You know, just like suppose you read a book written by a scientist, Albert Einstein or somebody, you know, theory of relativity. You cannot understand theory of relativity simply by knowing English, right? The purport has to be understood. The real meaning of has to be understood. So those who receive the mercy, those who have yasya deve para bhaktir, yatha deve tatha guru, you know, those who have unflinching faith and in the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Shri Krishna, and the Acharya, pure devotee, they, for them only, the purport of Vedas are revealed in the hearts. Otherwise, simply reading, you know, Max Muller also, he read all Vedas, you know, but he was such a rascal. He completely concocted and blasphemed Vedas and Vedic literature. Right, there is one guy, H.G. Wilson. He wrote he translated Vishnu Purana. Right, so nobody becomes a devotee by reading those books. But you know, Srila Prabhupada explained, millions of people have become devotees all over the world because Prabhupada is, when we read Prabhupada books, Prabhupada is revealing the real purport of all Vedic literatures. Right. In our hearts, right? That is why we must very regularly read Srila Prabhupada books. Actually, Srila Prabhupada worked so hard, right, to reveal this. Many life members, many people who we come across, they say, until the time we read Prabhupada books, we did not know that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Yeah? As soon as you open a book, you ask any child in our Hare Krishna movement, you ask Krishna, who is Krishna? They will immediately say, Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. A small child in Hare Krishna temple, they are far, far better than all these tapasvis and jnanis who are wasting their time, right? Doing tapasya and doing meditation and all. So it is only by the mercy of Prabhupada, we are able to understand Krishna. Atri Muni, he was standing on one leg, performed austerities and penance for thousands of years, right? After performing so many severe austerities, he performed. After doing all the austerities, still he did not know who is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Right? That is why Dattatreya, you know, all the three have come, Vishnu, Mahabrahma, Vishnu, Maheshwar. Because he did not know who is God. Right? A small child in Hare Krishna movement, a new bhakta in Hare Krishna movement, knows that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So even though these brahmanas, they are performing all these religious sacrifices, the Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, all the ingredients, you know, all the ritvij, everything that is connected to the sacrifice is a simply opulence of Krishna. They are all coming from Krishna. And the yajnartat karmano anyatra lokoyam karma bandana. You know, everything should be performed for the satisfaction of Yajna Purusha, Krishna. So the purpose of performing the sacrifices, you know, is Krishna, to satisfy Krishna. And that same Krishna sent messengers that we are feeling hungry. You know, please give me some food. These guys, they did not, Sukadeva Goswami, he is very angry. He is saying that, my dear Parikshit Maharaj, if you had been there, you would have, Harindama, he was addressing Parikshit Maharaj as Harindama, that these rascals, they are, because Vishnu Thakur says that, you know, Sukadeva Goswami is feeling very angry that, you know, Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, from whom all these ingredients that are meant to use for in the sacrifice. Yeah, that same personality is coming and asking, please give me some food, I am feeling hungry. And these rascals, they are not even paying respect to the coward boys who are the close friends of Krishna. That is why he is telling, my dear Parikshit, if you had been there, you know, you even without seeing that they are brahmanas of high caliber, you would have punished them. You know, how can they do that? Right? Like that. So, they did not say yes and they did not say no also. Why? Because they were thinking, how can we give food to the non-Brahmins first? And that is why they didn't say yes. They did not say no also because they thought, we are not saying that we will not give you food, but after we eat food, we will give you. Right? So, you can understand. No use of, you know, that's why sometimes they people ask, once I was in BIA, somebody asked, do you have Vedas? I said, yeah, I have. Then I given it in Bhagavad Gita, you know. What is this? Yeah, this is, you know, because Krishna says, Traigunya Vishaya Veda, Nistraigunya Bhavarjuna. Right? In second chapter of Bhagavad Gita. He said, my dear Arjuna, you know, raise above these three, you know, three modes of nature. So all these Vedas and all, they are, you know, within three modes of nature. So you reject them. Nidvandohi Nitya Sattvastu, Niryoga Kshema Atmavan. So Krishna himself is saying, reject the Vedas. So why you want to read Vedas? Right? So essence of Vedas is Bhagavad Gita, right? Anybody who knows, Krishna says, right? That aham sarvasya prabhaha, matta sarvam pravartate, iti matva bhajante maam, buddha bhava samanvita. So anybody who knows that I am the source of everything and everything is coming from me, they in great love, they worship me. You know, that's it. If you know this verse, 10th chapter, 8th verse, you know everything. Okay? There is no need to read anything else like that. So, then they came back. Coward boys, they are very, very disappointed and they felt very disrespected that, you know, Krishna's friends, they have went and then Krishna himself was asking for food, saying that we are hungry. They did not give. So, very disappointed, they came back and they have narrated what all happened to Krishna and Balaram. So, after hearing this, Krishna laughed. So, Prabhupada says, the meaning of Krishna's laughter is that, that is the how, you know, that is how a beggar, you know, we say, you know, beggars cannot be choosers, right? That is the nature of the profession of the begging, that you cannot expect every time that, you know, you go for begging, you know, that you will get something, you know, that they will give you something, you know, sometimes they won't give. So, Prabhupada says, Krishna is indicating that when we go for begging, when they refuse, you should not become disappointed. You know, that is the way of begging. So, you go to someone else, they will give. Right? Like our life membership teachers, we should know. Right? Sometimes we see, we go there and then we wait for 1 hour, 2 hour. And then he says, Swamiji, agla mahina aao. Right? Then devotees, that time we were traveling in the rickshaw, we used to give galis, rascal. 2 ghanta baitha hai, bithaya. Wo yehi baat pehle bol dete. Right? You know, we are sometimes, you know, you Kalbadevi Road, there is no AC room, waiting room and all, you know, with a small, in a small bench, we used to wait. After waiting for 2 hours, so we used to give them galis. Right? So, after that we came to know, we should not feel disappointed, that's how it is. Right? Sometimes, I used to go one donor, every time I go, Swamiji, achha nahi ho raha hai, business achha nahi chal raha hai, not going on well, this, that. Every time I would see a new car outside his camp, you know, office. Then one day I was so disgusted, I told him, if you keep saying that, you know, my business is not doing well, one day Krishna will make your words true. Then he is so upset. No, aisa mat boliye, le lijiye. Right? So, it was like that. So, but Prabhupada is saying, that's how it is. Then Krishna told the coward boys, now you go to those, their wives, these brahmanas' wives, you go there. You know, they are very, very devoted to me. They will give definitely the food. So, Vishnath Chakravarti says so that covered boys may ask, how they will give? How they will give? Because their husbands and now they are non-devotees, they did not give. So, they will not allow their wives also to give. Right? Then, Krishna says that, because my usita dhiya, then he said, these brahmanas, these wives, they will not care for them. Because in their mind, I am always residing. Because, you know, I am residing in their mind always. Only bodies, they are staying with their husbands. But in their minds, I am only residing. So, they will not care. This time, Krishna told, ask in my name. Because they have got so much love for me. You ask in my name. But please don't tell that I am feeling hungry. If they, because I am their priyatama, because they have so much love for me, if they hear that I am feeling hungry, they will feel very bad. They will feel become very distressed. That is why you don't tell that I am feeling hungry. Right? So, then they said, go and ask. They will definitely give. And then all the coward boys, they went and offered their obeisance to the wives. They were all sitting there because they had to take part in the sacrifice. They are dressed very nicely, wearing very expensive sarees, silk sarees, and you know, decorated themselves with the, you know, very beautiful earrings and necklaces and flowers in their hair. And they are waiting. And then these boys, they went and offered obeisance and said, Krishna and Balram, they are here nearby, right? As soon as then they said, as soon as they heard that Krishna, and immediately they fainted in great ecstasy. They said, oh my dear Lord, Priyatam Krishna has come, my Priyatam, our Priyatam Krishna has come, like that, thinking like that, you know, they fainted in ecstasy. And then in order to bring them to consciousness, that is, then they had to use a technique that, you know, actually Krishna is feeling hungry, he wanted some food. He had to, because Krishna told, please don't tell them, but these ladies, so behosh ho gaya tha. So in order to bring them to consciousness, to specify, to say some bold words so that, you know, they'll become. So as soon as they heard, Krishna is feeling hungry, and they got up and they were cursing themselves that how foolish we are, that, you know, when Krishna is feeling hungry, we are actually fainted, you know. Instead, we should be immediately packing prasad for Krishna. Like that. And then immediately they got up, and there are four kinds of foodstuffs they already, because huge sacrifice is going to take place. So there were very various kinds of, there are four types of foodstuffs, right? So they were all packed in very nicely in, you know, big, big handas. And immediately they carried their, you know, bartans filled with prasadam, you know, and they ran towards Krishna, where Krishna and Balram were there. Right? When they entered the forest of, you know, Vrindavan, they saw among the Ashoka trees, you know, Krishna is loitering around, you know, beautifully, they saw Krishna like that. And then the beautiful words that, you know, Shyamam Hiranya Paridim Vanamalya Barha Dhatu Pravalana Tavesham Anuvratamse. So, the beautiful description of Krishna standing there, you know, it is given by Sukadeva Goswami. So, Shyamam Hiranya Paridim, Shyamam, you know, is bluish black, right? Like it is said that when Vasudeva was carrying Krishna first time to Gokul, you know, white rained, megha, white rained. So, Harishauriji comments that these clouds are, you know, thundering. Why? Because from now onwards, you know, all the kavis, you know, they will compare you with my color. Now, Megashyama, you know, like that, we are friends now. Right? We are friends, bluish, blackish clouds, like that. So, his complexion was dark blue. And then, garment, golden, right? Like, Krishna, we wear all kinds of different colors, but in the scriptures, it's always described that Krishna is wearing Pitambar Vastra, right? That's even Bhishmadev also, you know, explained, right? Tribhuvanakamanam tamalavarnam ravikara gauravara ambara dadane. So, there also, Bhishmadev is explaining the beauty of Krishna, right? That when the sun rays are falling on the yellowish cloth of Pitambar Vastra, there is some reflection is taking place and it's creating a beautiful hue. Like that, in the same way, here also, Shyamam Hiranya Paridim, you know, because of the falling of the sun rays on the yellowish cloth of Krishna, the sun rays are reflecting. So it is looking like golden, you know, Hiranya Paridim. Vanamalya Barha, you know, Krishna is always wearing Vaijayanti Mala, you know, consisting of five kinds of fragrant flowers. You know, five. Unfortunately, we don't get so much fragrant flowers. We have to use this stupid, you know, gulab. Because in Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, Krishna doesn't like gulab. Because, you know, gulab has, you know, any flowers that are coming from thorny trees, you know, Sri Vaishnavas, they don't use. Because Krishna doesn't like, because he feels that when the devotees, they pluck the flowers, they may get hurt by the thorns. That's why he doesn't want. Right? Either though some Chinese use karte hai. But what to do? But actually Vaijayanti Mala, you know, there are five kinds of beautiful fragrant flowers. Like the, so this is a pastime, you know. Every day, whole day, the gopis, Srimati Radharani, headed by Srimati Radharani, they keep on making garlands. You know, this is a garland making, is a beautiful service. Right? So, Krishna, they give a garland, and then spiritual world, it doesn't get contaminated, it doesn't get, fade away. But still, you know, Krishna takes away, because all the gopis, they are making so many garlands throughout the day. So, Krishna wants to please everybody. Right? So, Krishna will take out the garland, you know, Kaushalya Mataji was describing, when Prabhupada and entourage, they entered Surat. So many devotees, you know, entire Surat was there. People were, you know, showering flowers. And people are mad. And so many devotees there offering garlands. And then Prabhupada was filled with garlands. So but Prabhupada would not say no to new garland. So he would take out one garland, give it to the garland to that person, and he will take that garland. You know, Mahaprasad. And they were also very happy. Right? Previously, there was no Guru Puja, right? First time Guru Puja was started in Juhu temple only. Previously, in Western temples and all, when Prabhupada would come back from the morning walk, all the devotees, they would line up in the at the entrance of the temple. And then every devotee gives one flower to Prabhupada. So Prabhupada would give back that flower to that devotee, and then he would receive the new flower. Like that, that was the system. Like that. Anyway. So, Vanamalya Barha, and then Krishna is always wearing, you know, peacock feathers. Right? One day, Krishna was playing flute. You know? When he was playing flute, all the peacocks, they became very ecstatic and they started dancing. You know? They started dancing. And then Krishna was very pleased. Then the peacocks, they said, "You played flute so nicely that we are dancing. We want to give you some gift." Krishna said, "Why not give? Because usually if you know, play some good music and all, you get dakshina, right? All this." So the peacock said, "We want to also give you because you played so nicely flute. What do you want? No, please." Then they gifted their peacock feathers. They are so beautiful. That is why, since then, Krishna started wearing peacock feathers. Like that. సో వనమల్లి బర్హ ధాతు ప్రవాల నటవేషం అనువ్రతాంశే. ఇఫ్ యు సీ అవర్ డీటీస్, యూ కృష్ణ ఈజ్ వైటిష్ డీటీ, రైట్? యు నో వై కృష్ణ ఈజ్ వైట్? రాధారాస్ ఫేర్ ఈజ్ వైట్ ఇన్ అవర్ టెంపుల్. ఎనీబడి నోస్? బికాస్ కృష్ణ ఈజ్ బ్లాకిష్ ఇన్ కలర్, రైట్? ఇన్ వృందావన్ అండ్ మాయాపూర్ యు సీ కృష్ణ అండ్ బలరామ్, కృష్ణ అండ్ దే ఆర్ కృష్ణ డీటీస్ బ్లాక్, రైట్? సో ఇట్ ఈస్ సెడ్ అవర్ వై వైట్ డీటీస్, బికాస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ సెడ్ దట్ దీస్ వైట్ డీటీస్ ఆర్ రాధాలింగిత విగ్రహ. బికాస్ కృష్ణ, వెన్ కృష్ణ ఎంబ్రేసెస్ ఎంబ్రేస్డ్ బై రాధారాణి, హీ అస్యూమ్స్ ద కలర్ ఆఫ్ రాధారాణి. దట్స్ వే దే ఆర్ కాల్డ్ రాధాలింగిత విగ్రహ. అదర్వైజ్ కృష్ణ ఈజ్ బ్లాకిష్ ఇన్ కలర్. సో వీ కెనాట్ డూ ఆల్ దీస్ పెయింటింగ్స్ అండ్ ఆల్. సో ఆల్ ద కవర్డ్ బాయ్స్, there are so many minerals are available in Vrindavan forest when they go for you know gocharan leela. So they take all these various kinds of minerals and they paint on the cheeks of Krishna various flowers and various designs and all. That is why it is called Dhatu Pravala. So he is wearing a yellowish cloth, and then he on his head he is wearing a peacock feather, and then orange, Krishna is always wearing orange color turban, right? Orange color turban, and then beautifully decorated with various flowers of that are available in Vrindavan, and he is wearing Vanamalya Varaha Vaijayanti Mala, right? And then all the covered boys, they have painted on his cheeks. So in this vesha he is looking like just like a dramatist, dancing actor, natavesham, right? Anubratamshe. And then Krishna is standing in the tribanga form, and then on one hand he was actually resting with his right hand, resting on the shoulders of one of the covered boys, and in another hand he is actually carrying a lotus flower and twirling, right? Then Karnotpal Alaka Kapola, and then Krishna has a very beautiful blackish curly hair, right? Nowadays people they go to the barber shop and they want curly hair, right? Because curly hair is very beautiful, right? But Krishna is having naturally curly hair, right? But there is one joke said, the girls with the straight hair, they want to have curly hair. Girls with the curly hair, they want to have a straight hair. But the man, he is very happy if he can retain some hair. Right? Like that. But Krishna, I was reading second chapter, 10th canto. Krishna, when he is born only, he is, Gumrulu Bhal. Chandra Alaka Kapola means a person looks very beautiful when these hairs, they fall on the forehead little bit. It is described. So Krishna's hair little bit fell on the, Alaka Kapola fell on the forehead, and then Gumrulu, blackish, curly hair, blackish curly hair, and then Mukabjahasam. The entire the beauty of Krishna, that is why 10th canto Bhagavatam, Prabhupada said, smiling lotus face of Krishna, right? Our Radharaswari is always smiling. Many devotees there, many life members, and they say, your Bhagavan is always smiling, right? So Krishna is always smiling, and that smile, completely enchants all the three worlds, and the gopis, they simply become captivated simply by seeing Krishna smile. And when all these elderly covered women, when they come to Mother Yashoda to complain, your Lala is stealing this, you're doing like this, he passes urine, if there is no makan is available, he pinches our boys, he feeds them so much, the monkeys, when the monkeys don't eat anymore, they say, who wants your stupid butter? Even monkeys also are not eating, right? He makes so many plans to steal butter, like that. So Mother Yashoda, she hears all these complaints and wanted to chastise Krishna, and then she looks at him. And then Krishna has this weapon, you know. He gives his beautiful smile. Right? With very innocent smile he gives. And then that's it. Mother Yashoda changes her mind. How can I chastise such a beautiful boy? So this is the main highlight of Krishna's beauty is his smile. You know, that smile enchants all the three worlds. Like that. So why Krishna is twirling the lotus flower in his hand? Because he is indicating that your lotus like hearts are in my hand and I am just, you know, twirling them. Like that. Then prayah shuta priyatamodaya karnapure yasmin nimagnamanasastam atakshirandre antapravesya suchiram parirabhyatapam prajnam yatha vimatayo vijahur narendra. Prayah shuta priyatamodaya. All of you must be wondering how, you know, the brahmanas' wives who never come out, you know, apashya Surya bolte hain, they never come out, how they became such great devotees, right? Because it is said prayah shuta priyatamo udaya, right? Priyatam ke bare mein they are hearing all the time about Krishna. From whom? They were not attending any Bhagavad Sapta, right? They are not attending any Bhagavad Sapta. From whom they are hearing? It is said that all these betel nut sellers, fruit selling ladies, and all these sabjiwalas, you know, they are spiritual masters of Brahmana's wives. Because they were always coming, you know, like all of you know the story, you know, how one fruit seller lady, she came and, you know, was trying to, you know, give fruits to Krishna. Like that. So like that, they all come, you know, all these pan sellers, sabjiwalas, you know, previously, all these malls and all, they were not there. Even in our childhood also, all the sabjiwalas, they used to come to our house, right? So all these people, they would come and they would see, and all these, of course, some of the brahmanas also, they would, every time there is some danger, Mother Yashoda would call them and perform some puja and all that. They all will come. And they would describe, after seeing Krishna's wonderful pastimes, they go back and narrate their pastimes. So they heard from betel nut sellers, fruit sellers, ladies, all these people they learned, they heard. So Priyatama Udaya, Karnapure, their ears are always filled with Krishna Katha. Right? Always filled with Krishna Katha. So, just like, you know, some of the ladies, they don't take out the earrings in the night time, any time, because if you take out the earrings, that holes will get filled up. So that is why, you know, all the time earrings should be worn. Otherwise, something, you know, just like that, you know, just like the ladies, they wear earrings all the time. 24 hours. Like that, we should wear Krishna Katha in our hearts all the time. Krishna Katha should be filled, you know, in our ears all the time. Prabhupada writes in the last chapter of Krishna book that anybody who reads these pastimes of Krishna book, who memorizes them, who repeats them, they will simply achieve love of God. Simply achieve love of God and will go back home back to God. Right? All of you, please take a vow that every day you will read Krishna book. Right? Prabhupada gave a simple formula. Right? Simple formula. That every day you read Krishna book. And now automatically, if you keep on reading, you will simply remember Krishna's pastimes. Right? Simply. That it becomes a, you know, second nature. Once Prabhupada went to American consulate in San Francisco, to get a visa extension, and that lady, surprisingly, she asked, she's an American, she asked Prabhupada, Swamiji, you say that all the time you have to remember Krishna, how it is possible? Because we have to do some work also, no? like that. Then Srila Prabhupada replied that, you know, because you are very busy in your work, will you stop eating? Will you stop wearing cloth? Will you, you know, stop sleeping? It is like that, you know, if you love Krishna, then you can remember him all the time, whether you are busy or wherever, whatever you are doing. He replied to that American lady. So like that, the focus, even Rukmini Devi also, she became a great devotee simply by hearing from the sages about Krishna. Right? Like that, here also, these Brahmanas' wives, they became great devotees. You know, Praya Shruta Priyatama Udaya Karna Pure Yasmin Rata Yasmin Imagna Manasastam Atakshirandrai. Because they were only hearing about Krishna, and they had developed so much love for Krishna, then they wanted to see Krishna with their eyes. Right? So then because of not able to see Krishna, you know, they are feeling great separation. So when they came in front of Krishna, they simply took Krishna, you know, from their eyes, from the holes of their eyes. They sent Krishna into their hearts. And to their heart's content, Suchiram means for a long time, they embraced Krishna in their hearts. And Parirabhyatapam, like that, they have given up their fire of separation, feelings of separation. You know, and all the pain, just like the sages, you know, by merging with the super soul, you know, the consciousness, super consciousness, they give up their pain of material existence in the same way. Srila Prabhupada writes, very beautiful, please remember this, in Krishna book he writes that if you see, it is said that they have achieved oneness. So Prabhupada says, Krishna was there personally, individually, on one side. All the Brahmanas' wives, they existed separately, individually. But still, they have achieved oneness. Because, Prabhupada says, a lover serves the beloved, loves the beloved, without a pinch of personal consideration. What is that? What is oneness? Prabhupada says, that is called oneness. What is that oneness? A lover serves the blood without a pinch of personal consideration. Other day I was explaining, right, that this Krishna consciousness, you know, when Prahlad Maharaj says, Iti Pumsharpita Vishnu, Bhaktishe Navalakshana, you know, create a Bhagavati Adha, Tanmanya Dhitam Uttamam. So Srila Prabhupada wrote a beautiful purport that actually, in general, the people perform activities with mind, body and words and dedicate the results of that activities to Krishna. But in this Krishna consciousness process, Prabhupada says, you first dedicate mind, body and words. You first dedicate mind, body and words to Krishna first. And then perform activities that are pleasing to Krishna. So in the first instance, people perform activities that are pleasing to them and offers the results to Krishna. But in Krishna consciousness, Prahlad Maharaj says, you should directly serve Krishna. Means, first you offer mind, body and words to Krishna, then perform activities that are pleasing to Krishna. So that is highest level of surrender. Not that, you know, I want to do something, right? Spiritual master says, you know, but the highest kind of surrender is whatever the spiritual master says, you just do it without questioning. Prabhupada says in 18th chapter Bhagavad Gita, a sold out animal has no rights. Whatever the master says, he has to do it. Like that. So this is the Prabhupada's purport. So, Lord Krishna, who is Antaryami in everybody's hearts, he understood the feelings of the Brahmana's wives. And he said, Swagatam va Mahabhaga Asyatam Karvamakim Yanno Didriksha Prapta Upapannam Idam Hi Vaha. My dear wives of Brahmanas, please welcome. What can I do for you? What seva I can do for you? You have come here is very, very auspicious for you. You have come here to see me is very, very auspicious for you. So Vishnu Thakur comments that actually he is telling to the Brahmana's wives the same words that he has spoken to the gopis also. When the gopis came, he said the same thing. Swagatam vo Mahabhaga. Then he is saying that please come, please be comfortable. You know, what can I actually, you have done so, you have so much prema for me. Actually, I cannot do anything for you. I will remain a debtor. But please stay here a long time and look at me. Take my darshan. Because that is the most auspicious thing in the world. Right? Most auspicious thing in the world. Many times, I am saying this many times, that when Ramchandra was going to meet Kaikeyi, so many people, they have gathered around to see, have a glimpse of Lord Ramchandra. It was said that there was so many people that even a grain of sand also will not fall. And Valmiki Muni, he quoted a beautiful verse saying the meaning of his, that everybody's lips, there are only two sentences. Right? Has Rama seen you? Did you see Rama? Right? It's very important, you know, Krishna, Radha's way also look at us. Right? Then, did you see Rama? Or has Rama seen you? Right? Then he says that if Rama has not seen you, and if you have not seen Rama, you know, your own Atma will curse you. Your life is a waste. Right? So every day, if you cannot have darshan of Shri Radha Ras Bihari, right? It's a waste. Our life is a waste. Right? Of course, now we have internet. We can have, you know, photo downloaded, you know, Facebook. That is also nice. Right? Like Radha Govind Maharaj always says that there is one guy, one person who is Surdas, who is Andha, you know. Every day he used to go have darshan of Banki Bihari. Some of these naughty boys, they were, you know, ridiculing that that Brahmana, that Surdas. That, aap kis liye aate ho har din? Andhe ho, kya dekhte ho tu? Right? Unhone bahut achha bola. Mai to andha ho, lekin Banki Bihari to andha nahi na. Ho to humko dekhenge. Right? Maharaj says that every day if you come to the temple, and then when Krishna's glance falls on us, right, our bodies become very healthy and our consciousness becomes purified. Right? So rather than to see Krishna, we should come to temple to be seen by Krishna. That is more important, you know. That is why please, all the devotees, they pray, my dear Lord Radha Ras Bihari, please cast your cooling glance on me. Right? Why do we dance? Right? The person who jumps the highest, right? He is saying that I am the most fallen. Please look at me. Right? Please look at me. Not that, you know, we Prabhupada says in Chaitanya Charitamrita, many people, they think that when you come to the temple, right, they think that they should ask something for Krishna, from Krishna. But actually Prabhupada says there is no need to ask anything from Krishna. It is your duty to come to see Krishna. It is simply your duty to come and pay offerings to Krishna. That's it. That's why Krishna is saying, look at me, you have my darshan. Right? One devotee, every day, you know, he used to do like this. Every day, you know, Gaur Nitya ke samne. One day, he's my friend, I asked, ye kya hai? What is this? He says, I only want only 10 lakhs. So there is no need to ask any of these things. Like that. So, then he said very beautiful verse, that Nanvadda mai kurvanti, you know, kushala swartha darshinaha, ahetyuki avyavahitam bhaktim atma priya yatha. Right? Nanvadda mai kurvanti. You know, those personalities who know their self-interest, kushala swartha darshinaha, you know, they will worship me without any cause, without any demand, and without any interruption, you know, abhyavahitam, right? Because I am most dear to atma priya yatha, I am most dear to like that. Krishna Chakrakur comments that even though Krishna understands their unflinching love for him, because he wanted to show them mercy and fulfill their desires, heart's desire, but still Leela, it is not the time, you know, for doing this Leela, because it becomes rasavasa. Rasavasa means people will criticize Krishna, because Krishna is a coward boy and the Brahmana's wives. So if any connection with Krishna, a coward boy Krishna with Brahmana's wives, looks very bad. So that is why Leela Shakti, even though Krishna wanted to show mercy to Brahmana's wives and wanted to fulfill their heart's desire, still Leela Shakti, seeing that, you know, this is not the right time, you know, made Krishna speak words of laden with Aishwarya Bhav, you know, because this is Aishwarya Bhav that he is speaking, that all the sages and all, they worship me because I am very dear to them, and those who know, you know, like that. So in the love, all these things he will not speak, right? He will not speak. So why? Because the rasa is not fulfilled. So that is why Krishna spoke these words, that, you know, yeah, he appreciated that, you know, what you have done is right thing, because I am most dear to the all the atma priya yatha, you know, it is the right thing to do, you know, one should worship me without any demands, without any causelessly, and then without any interruption, you know, you should worship me, because even the before sages, many of the sages, they worship me like this. Then he said, whatever is dear to me, dear to you, like intelligence, body, mind and all, it is because of me. Then he instructed them that, you know, you please go back to your husbands. You know, they are because they need your presence for performing the sacrifice. So please you go back. Then the wives of the brahmanas, they said, maivam vibho rahati bhavan gaditam nushamsham satyam kurushva nigamam tava padamulam prapta vayam tulasidama padavashrashtam kesher nivodum atilangya samasta bandhun. The same words, when the gopis also they came, Krishna told them, you please go back. Then they didn't go back, right? The same words they have also spoken, maivam vibho arhati gaditam nushamsham, right? So because they were saying satyam krushva tava padamulam, because you have said in Bhagavad Gita, sarvadharman parityajya mamekam sharanam raja aham tam sarvapapyebhyo mokshayishyami mashuchaha. Anybody who surrenders to me, they will not come back again in this way. Yadgatvan nivartante taddhama paramam mama. They will not come back again to this material world. You know, ye yathamam prapadyante tam sateva bhajamyaham. You said, as you surrender, I reward. So please make those words true. Right? Now we have given up everything. We have come to you. Now how you are saying, please do go back? No, we will not go back. Because you have promised in the scriptures that anybody who surrenders to you, they will not go back to this material world again. So please fulfill your word. Satyam kurushva tava padamulam. Nigamam tava padamulam. Nigamam means Vedas, Vedic literature. Then the Krishna may say that actually I am a coward boy. You are all Brahmana's wives. You are Brahmins. How is it possible that, you know, you have to, how can you surrender to me? I am a coward boy. You are like that. Then Brahmana's wife said, we don't know all those things. We already surrendered to you. Right? So we want to take the dust of your lotus feet on our heads. Then your husband and all, they will object. Your sons and all, fathers and all, they will object. We don't care for them. Atilangya. Samasta bandhun. We cut all our relationships, you know, with them. Because it is said that, because of hearing from all the betel nut sellers and all, they developed love for Krishna. The brahmanas, they were suspicious what these ladies are up to. That's why they have stopped their relationship with their wives, because they are no longer liking their wives, because they are thinking that they are in love with somebody else. It's already happened. So we don't care. We already given up. Then Krishna may say that how it is possible, you know, that I am a coward boy and then you are all brahmana's wives. If you surrender to me like this, the public will not like it. You know, I myself will breaking, setting up a wrong, standard. And then for me, I am a coward boy. If I play with the coward girls, that is more appropriate than playing with the brahmana's wives. Then brahmana's wife said, that we don't bother. No problem. If you have a problem to directly associate with us, we have no problem. No, we will simply remain in the forest like Vanadevatas. And whatever your tulsi garlands that are, touched by your chest, or all the flower garlands that are, fallen from your gopis' friends, we will keep them and put on our heads. And we are simply will become satisfied. If you can get the dust of your lotus feet, some of the tulsi garlands that we can, from your maha garlands we can get, that we will be satisfied. We will not disturb you. We will not disturb you. Then they said, anyway, our husbands and wives and all, the brothers and all, they will not accept us because we are apashya surya. We are aristocratic brahminis. So nobody, even the sun also will not see us. Will not look at us. So under such circumstance, even though they were objecting, we did not care for them, and we came back, running to you, who is known for you are known as a debauchee in Vrindavan. So after associating with you, who will accept us? Like that. So we are staying here. Like that. So all the youth boys, you should know. Right? If you want to surrender to Krishna, Rasaraj Babu always says, in the Western world, America and all, people don't join because of great sinful activities, Mahapap. In India, they find difficult to join the Hare Krishna movement because of Ma Bap. So, Ma Bap, if you want to join Hare Krishna, some trouble you have to give it. Ma Bap means father and mother. right? Some trouble. You have to take a decision. You have to give. They will feel some pain. But of course, when the time comes, many people they ask how to join, whether we should join or not. This that. Actually, just like when the ulti aata hai, when you feel you start feeling omitting, you cannot stop it, right? You have to go. Like that. In the same way, when that Krishna catches you, your heart, he steals your heart, Hari, that's why he's known as Hari, then nothing will stop you. You will simply run to Hare Krishna Mandir. So many people say, they used to tell me in my office and all, Hare, don't go to Hare Krishna, they are, basement, and after now I'm head pujari. They said in the basement, they have drugs, Or they take out your kidney and they sell, like that they used to tell me. But nothing stopped me, because I was so liking it so much. So when Krishna drags you, nothing will can stop you. So, but from our effort also, we should be ready to give some trouble to our parents, our relatives and all, because they feel in India they are very attached to the son, right? What to speak of ordinary mothers. Even mother Sachi also blamed Advaita Acharya because because of him. Vishwarupa has joined Hare Krishna, like that. So this is called surrender. We don't care. Then anyway, time is up. So there is one lady. Then Krishna told them that because you love me, you have unflinching love for me. And are dedicated to my happiness. Because you have unflinching love for me and you are dedicated to my happiness. Please do not anything against my intentions. Against my intentions. Please don't be stubborn. Please go back. Right? Then the Brahmana says, they will not accept me as again because we already left them. Right? Aisa bolte hai na. Hamara zamane mein aisa koi aurat, any girl, even in relatives' house also, she slept overnight. They are rejected. We came here to meet a, you know, such a bad reputation you have got. So why they will accept? No, no, no. I am Supreme Personality Godhead. I will advise them. Then Krishna says, even the demigods will approve. Why? Because Vishnu's Raghu says that because they are performing sacrifices, demigods might have come. And these brahmanas, they will consult demigods. Well, what to do? Because they have gone to see Krishna. No, because they have gone to see Krishna. Should we accept them back? Demigods also will approve. Because this is the right thing. Even though I have not associated with you, even if I have associated with you, right? Even if I have associated with you, still they will accept. Like Bhaktacharya Maharaj, he says that many people, they say Krishna is immoral, Krishna is immoral. Right? Bhaktacharya Maharaj asked, he was giving seminar one class. But what is immoral? He asked one devotee, suppose your wife comes and tells you that yesterday night I was with Krishna, dancing with Krishna. How will you react? Will you reject your wife? He said, no, Maharaj. I will embrace her. Aray, she is so fortunate that she danced with Krishna. Right? So he says that those who are thinking that so-and-so is my wife, you know, he is immoral. Because every woman is wife of Krishna. Right? That's why Krishna, Prabhupada gave deity's name in Paris, Radha Parishishwar. Right? Because Prabhupada said, women in Paris, they are the most beautiful. Right? Of all on earthly planet so far. So Prabhupada said, Krishna has come to enjoy with Paris Bhamas. Right? That is why he gave the name of Radha Parishishwar. Like that. So everybody is a wife of Krishna. Actually, if somebody is saying that she is my wife, I should enjoy with her, he is immoral, not Krishna. That is the highest understanding. Anyway, so they all went back. But one lady, she was stopped from going to Krishna. She, with intense love for Krishna, she gave up her body. So Vishnu Thakur comments that the Krupa Shakti of Krishna took out the body of material body, but she gave her a spiritual body, and then she came with all the brahmanas' wives, and then she also enjoyed with Krishna. You know, she also enjoyed with Krishna, and all the other ladies also, by Krupa Shakti, she has transformed, Yogamaya has transformed the bodies of brahmanas' wives into spiritual bodies. And since then, there was no connection of the brahmanas' wives with the brahmanas at all. Then it is said that, you know, all these brahmanas' wives, like Bali Maharaj and Sukadeva Goswami, they are Krupa Siddhas. He made a very pertinent point that Gopis, even though Krishna told them to go back, they did not go back. Right? But the brahmanas' wives, they went, they had to go back because Krishna told them. But Vishnu Thakur concludes that both of them, they got the Krishna Prema, Krishna's mercy they have got. Like that. After they reached, seeing the ecstasy of brahmanas' wives, all these brahmanas, they cursed themselves, you know, hell, to hell with our brahminical birth, to hell with our Vedic knowledge, to hell with our religious principles, to hell with our austerities and penances. These ladies, I don't know how they got so much love for Krishna. You know, so our lives are wasted. Krishna, even though he is husband of goddess of fortune, he came to beg. You know, people may accuse, you know, how is God if he is begging? Because to bewilder us, you know, to show us what kind of rascals we are, that, you know, Krishna did this pastime. Then Prabhupada says in the Krishna book, even though they know that Krishna is the Supreme Personality Godhead, they should have surrendered to Krishna, because they did not go because they are afraid of Kamsa. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. So this is a wonderful pastime of brahmana's wives, blessed. You know, from this we can understand, what are the main points we can understand? Overcoming all kinds of obstacles, we should surrender to Krishna. Our goal of life should be, we should completely surrender to Krishna, giving up all kinds of, right, religious principles. Right? Other day I was telling, how many of you remember, what are the five super excellent qualities of Krishna? Please raise your hands. Five super excellent qualities of Krishna. Sandeep, bolo. Anybody knows? Arey, come on. How many times? Two times I already told. No. They are. So one of the qualities, first one is, please meditate. Krishna is coming now, Janmashtami. Krishna, before Krishna appeared, you know, Ganga's glories, purification of Ganga, strength of the Ganga's purification quality, strength is very much glorified. But when Krishna appeared, Krishna defeated the glories of Ganga. Krishna's name and fame in Dwarka Vamsh, because defeated. Number two, Krishna appeared, when Krishna appeared, he delivered both demons and the devotees. Right? They got the same benefit. And number three, even though Lakshmi Devi, she is known as Chanchala, she is very attached to serving the lotus feet of Narayana. But such Lakshmi Devi, she gave up lotus feet of Narayana, came to Belvan, to doing tapasya, to get association of Krishna, Shyam Sundar Krishna. And number four, his holy name is the most powerful. It is called Shrutamatha. Shrutamatha means chanting of the holy name is so powerful. Krishna's holy name is so powerful. Like it is said that 1000 names of Vishnu, and then if you chant 3 times of Rama, it is equal to chanting 1000 names. But if you chant one Krishna's name, it is equivalent to chanting 3 times of Rama's name, right? And Shrutamata means this chanting of the holy name of Krishna. Shrutamata means crushed all other process of spiritual realization. All other process. And then number five, simply by speaking one verse, Saradharman Parityajya Mamekam Sharanam Vraja, Krishna has given the most simple religious principle to be followed. Prabhupada says, there are 20 types of Dharma Shastras. When Krishna says Sarvadharman Parityajya, he means that you give up all these 20 types of Dharma Shastra, all the religious principles that are described in these 20 types of Dharma Shastra, and follow one principle. What is that? Surrender to Krishna. These are the five super excellent qualities of Krishna. Remember, this is from the, I think, last but one chapter of Krishna book. Okay? Hare Krishna. Any questions, comments?